Namaskaram. Friends, today I welcome you to this session, which is a kind of a daring attempt to introduce the essential spirit of the music of South India that we call Carnatic music, and in the space of 45 minutes. This is the kind of challenge which is best described by the Tamil saying, try stuffing an elephant into a clay pot. However, we meet this challenge by adopting a specific perspective, and we focus on the three most important composers of Carnatic music, together called the Trinity: Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshitar, and Shyama Shastri. All three belong to the 18th century. More amazingly, they were contemporaries born in the same small town called Tirubarur in Tanjavur, Tamil Nadu. You can still see the houses where they were born there. They created a style that was absolutely their own. And their compositions together represent the most traditional and the most innovative aspects of Carnatic music. At this point, I think I should say that what we call Carnatic music today is at least 2,000 years old. It evolved for 2,000 years before the appearance of the Trinity in the 18th century. Ancient and medieval poetry, painting, sculpture, all these things show how music was a very important part of community life every day, as well as on festive occasions in royal courts and in the temples. We don't know how that music sounded, but we know that it was extremely complex because we have theoretical texts coming down from the centuries, through the centuries, which tell us it is so. Today, we will see how these three composers enriched this heritage with their original vision. We start with Shyama Shastri. If you go to Tanjavur, of course you'll think of the big temple, but go into a small, unassuming street in Tanjavur, where you have a modest little temple called the Bangaru Kamakshi Temple, and there you will see the goddess who was worshipped 6 times during the day by the priest, who was none other than Shyama Shastri. Go behind the temple and you will see his little house and the front platform in that house, where he sat and sang most of his songs in praise of the Devi. He identifies himself in every song as Shyama Krishna, that is his mudra. And he talks directly to the mother, calling her Meenakshi, Kamakshi, Nilayadakshi, or simply Ma Talli, which is my mother. The language is therefore very simple and repetitive. This is a child talking to the mother. Almost all the songs have the same message: mother, Ma Talli, come and save me. For Shastri, as well as his other illustrious contemporaries, music was worship. It was not a profession. He sought neither money, nor fame, nor disciples. And yet Shyama Shastri has left us some 300 compositions only, but each one is a gem, mostly in a format that we call the Kriti, which is the most popular format in Carnatic music, particularly in concerts. Many think that the compositions in Carnatic music are fixed and static, and you learn them and you repeat them and that's the end of the story. Far from it. Each composition varies with the performer, the stylistics, the school, and the maturity of the singer. Now, every Kriti is a bank which stores the raga and earns its compound interest when a musician sings it, musicians of every generation sing it. No wonder the guru tells the disciple, internalize the Kriti, as many Kritis as you can, in as many ragas as you can, and by as many different composers as you can, and then you can elaborate the raga with total command and authority. More, you will be able to breathe your own life into it. Today, we bring you a kriti by Shyama Shastri in an old raga called Purvi Kalyani, set to Shyama Shastri's favorite tala rhythm structure called Mishra Chapu, which is 1-2-3, 1-2-3-4. However, Shastri makes it more interesting for us, more intriguing for us, by reversing the count. And what you have is 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3. Now, what does it do? It makes the rhythm acquire a new lilt, a sprightliness, and also the melody shows different facets under this kind of rhythmic grid. Enjoy.
Ninnu vina gamari dikke varun naru ninnu vina gamari dikke varun naru ninnu vina gamari dikke varun na
Nikhilano kajanani
Yeah. kamita thapana dayagi lalita shama krishna sodari vedame ro
to say exactly where and when Carnatic music as we know it today began. But it is very clear that its sole force inheres in Tanjavur, in Tamil Nadu, where the Telugu Nayaka kings and later the Maratha Bhonsle kings patronized this music. However, at a time when musicians were moving from court to court, king to king, zamindar to zamindar, the three great composers showed absolute disdain for royal patronage. They remained aloof from the courts. Here's a story that illustrates Tyagaraja's attitude to royal patronage. One day, the king's messenger comes to his humble home and invites him to come to the Tanjavur court. This is the king's order. Tyagaraja does not say anything to the courtier. What he does is to burst into song, Nidhi Chala Sukhama, which is, what gives more joy, wealth or the grace of God? Bhakti has always been the wellspring of Carnatic music right from the beginning. And Tyagaraja, the most revered among the composers, undoubtedly the most influential figure in Carnatic music even today, followed the path of devotion or bhakti. After all, this pan-Indian tradition of bhakti began right here in Tamil Nadu in the 6th century. As we know, the bhakti tradition underscores personal devotion to the god and famously uses poetry and music to worship the godhead. It has no interest at all in the acquisition of material wealth or power. But heartfelt devotion does not mean lack of intellectual sophistication. A simple life does not mean that either. It is to Tyagaraja that Carnatic music owes its extensive knowledge of so many of its major ragas as well as innumerable ragas which are little known and very rare. In addition, he has left so many compositions with such a variety that a beginner, a child can sing them, and some of them can be an absolute challenge to the most seasoned master. Thanks to the fact that he had so many disciples, many compositions of Tyagaraja have come down to us and they have become the backbone of Carnatic music today, particularly in the concerts. And they offer tremendous scope for personal interpretation by each musician. The Kriti that we have chosen today is set in the majestic Raga Kamboji, which belongs to the Carnatic tradition in a very special and distinct way. The Kriti has an unusual structure. It has a Pallavi and 5 Charanams, no Anupallavi. What makes it absolutely delightful is that the lyric praises Lord Rama, making him one of us, by saying that he enjoys good music when there is a perfect blend of Raga, tala and bhava. This kind of exuberance in the kriti is best set off with another improvisational technique which belongs exclusively to Carnatic music. This is the mind-grabbing kalpanaswara, or the singing of solfa syllables within the rhythm structure. Shri Raghuvara Aprameya.
Shri Raghuvara Aprameya Raghuvara Aprameya.
sa sa ri ri ga ma ga ri ga ri ri sa ri sa ri da ra ma ma ga ma pa da si ta ma ga 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 ra ja du ta ni ga su ta ta su gu na ma ga na si
Oh,
or listening to Muthuswami Dikshitar's compositions, major compositions, is to feel as if you're climbing a towering mountain range with the vast blue sky above you. Dikshitar's slow pace and commanding rhythms magnify the majesty of the raga. And instead of Shyama Shastri's, "Ma, come and save me," or Tyagaraja's colloquial communicativeness, in Dikshitar we have imposing Sanskrit lyrics. They deal with formal descriptions of the gods, philosophic concepts, even esoteric forms of worship. And suddenly, you can see just why Carnatic music is visualized as connecting you to the cosmic vibrations. You move from nada to nada Brahman, and it heightens your consciousness. There is a fable to illustrate the uplifting power of Carnatic music. When his wife demanded gold and ornaments from Muthuswami Dikshitar, what could the poor man do? He immediately sang a song addressed to Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. And they say, the roof opened and it rained gold. But the real miracle was this. The wife suddenly didn't want it. Her inner eye had been opened, and what she now wanted was the gold of wisdom. It is generally believed that Carnatic music is extremely conservative, that it resists any kind of change, it is suspicious of outside influences, and it builds a wall against foreign infiltrations. All we have to do is to look at Muthuswami Dikshitar, and we will know that nothing can be farther from the truth. Most rooted as he is in tradition, Dikshitar is also most open to adventures and to experiments. Most astonishing is Dikshitar's fascination for Western music, which they say he heard from the British band in Fort St. George in Madras City. He has left us a whole series of what we call note swarams, notes and swaras, notes transformed to swaras, where he plays with Western notes and tunes. One of them is actually a prayer to the Mother Goddess set to the tune of God Save the King, the British national anthem. And we know that his brother, Balaswami, also shared this fascination because he introduced violin. He learnt the Western violin and introduced it. And today, the violin is an indispensable part of Carnatic music. Dikshitar also revels in introducing Hindustani ragas, not as feather-light pieces to be sung at the end of the concert, but major, noble-sounding, serious compositions. The way he handles Brindavana Saranga, Dvijavanti, which is Jayajayavanti, Hamir and Yamuna Kalyani, which is Yaman, makes it obvious that he not only traveled to the north, but he actually learned Hindustani music from some authentic source. May I sum up by saying that the three great composers that we have talked about now represent the essence of Carnatic music as it moves towards growth and evolution. The lifestyle and philosophy of these composers were reflected in their compositions. They propagated the ideals of virtue, simplicity, and devotion. However, let us not forget that they were not just good men. They were great artists, magnificent artists. They shaped the structure, the texture, the architectonics of what we call Carnatic music today, for future generations to take forward and make progress. We round off this presentation with two compositions by Muthuswami Dikshitar. One begins with the words Rama Rama Kali, set in the raga Ram Kali, which is imported from Hindustani music, of course. But it's not a cut and paste job. Muthuswami Dikshitar makes the raga integral to his aesthetics and to his own meditative and yogic development of melodic ideas. And after that, we sign off with a saucy little piece, which is one of the Notaswarams in the series where Muthuswami Dikshitar made his forays into Western music. Enjoy. Namaskaram.
Rama, Rama, Kali, Kalushaya, Vira. Rama, Rama, Kali, Kalushaya, Virama. Rama, Rama, Kali,
Guru Guha Pali Nijaya
शुभकरि सततमहम्
वन्दे मीनाक्षि त्वां सरसिजवक्त्रे पर्णे दुर्गे नतसुरवन्दे शक्ति
गुरुगुहपादिनि जगरुहचरणे
सुन्दरपाण्ड्यानल्गे माये सूरिजनाधारे सुन्दरराजसहोदरि गौरि शुभकरि सततमहम् शक्ति गुरुगुहपालिनि जनरुहचरणे गुरुगुहपालिनि जनरुहचरणे गुरुगुहपालिनि जनरुहचरणे।